अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास थ्री, इट्स आवर 15th लेक्चर ऑफ इंग्लिश है। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी न्यू ऑक्सफर्ड मॉडर्न इंग्लिश बुक 3। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ओपन पेज नंबर 43। एट द टॉप ऑफ द पेज राइट डाउन द डेट। यूनिट 5, मैसेज इन अ बॉटल। व्हाट्स टू नो, डिसाइडेड, मेड अप वंस माइंड अबाउट समथिंग, डिफिकल्टी, समथिंग नॉट डन ईजली, डिस्कवर्ड, फाउंड, uncovered, learned about, foolish, not clever, not bright, message, a short letter or word sent from one person to another, scampered, ran quickly and lightly, wondered, thought about with curiosity and doubt. So now we will start the reading. A long time ago, two children, Afia and Hassan, lived in a small fishing village by the sea in the south of Pakistan. So this story is about two children, Afia and Hassan, who lived in a small fishing village in south of Pakistan. They were good friends and lived next door to each other. Their fathers were both fishermen. There was no school in the village, so the children built sand castles, chased crabs, swam in the sea, and climbed coconut palms all day long. They were not going to school because there was no school in their village. So all day long they were in a beach area. They were building sand castles, chased crabs, climbed coconut palms all day. Castles mean kile. Coconut palms mean nariyal ka draht. Chased mean kekda. Crabs mean kekda. Chased mean taakub karna ya peecha karna. They had a wonderful life without any worries. One day they were playing on the beach when they found a large green bottle. Beach means sahil. With great difficulty the children took the cap off the bottle. Inside it found a piece of paper. What does it say? Cried Afia excitedly. So with great difficulty they opened the bottle and inside it they found a piece of paper. So Afia excitedly said, what does it say? Excitedly mean josh se. I don't know, replied Hassan. There is something writing on it, but we can't read. The children wonder what to do. Old Babu, the shopkeeper in the village, could read. He would be able to tell them what it said. They decided to go to him. They scampered along to the shop with the bottle and the paper. So they both wondered that what they will do. So in his mind came Old Babu, the shopkeeper in a village. He knows to read. So they scampered along to the shop with a bottle and paper. Wandered mean hairan, scampered mean dorna. Look, Babu, cried the children excitedly. Look what we discovered on the beach. Old Babu took the paper from the children. He put on his glasses and started to read. So Babu took the paper from the children and put on his glasses and started to read. Discovered mean daryaft karna. If you get this, said Old Babu, reading from the paper, please write to me. I am David and I live in a small fishing village in New Zealand. Here is my address. Old Babu pointed to the address on the paper. So this letter was from a boy named David who lives in a small fishing village in New Zealand, and he has mentioned his address. Here is the boy's address, he said. This bottle has come all the way from New Zealand. It is a country far away over the deep blue sea. You must write to David. He must be a small child just like you. Tell him that you found his message. The children looked down at their feet. They looked sad. So Babu told him that this letter is from a boy who live far, far away. You must have to write to the small child. He must be waiting for your message. So the children looked down at their feet and looked sad. Why are you looking so sad? Asked old Babu. We cannot read or write. Can we? Replied Afia quietly. We are foolish. You are not foolish at all, said old Babu. Why don't you learn? So they both were sad. So the old Babu asked, why are you sad? So they replied that we can't read or write. We are foolish. So the old Babu said, why don't you learn? There is no school here, said Hassan. How can we learn? I will teach you, said old Babu with a smile. So the old Babu replied that he will teach them. From that day, every afternoon, when the shop was quiet, the children sat with old Babu. He gave them paper and pencil and he taught them. Some months later, Afia and Hassan wrote a letter to David in New Zealand. He wrote back to them. The months went by, the years went by. Afia and Hassan still write to David. Now they are nearly as old Babu was when he first read them the message in the bottle. So from that day, every afternoon they went to old Babu shop and he taught them. So after some months, Afia and Hassan were able to write a letter to David. So years went by and they were as old as old Babu. Now they can read and write. So this is the end of unit 5. Thank you and Allah Hafiz.